The Wix Model Context Protocol, or MCP Server, enables you to search through Wix documentation, generate code, and make API calls to your Wix site using an AI client. It gives AI-powered tools the resources they need to help you write Wix SDK code, execute Wix-specific tasks, and generally speed up your workflow as you develop your project. Let's go over the MCP setup process. First, make sure you have Node.js version 20 or higher installed. If you're not sure what version you have installed, run node-v in your terminal. Next, we'll open our IDE. In this tutorial, we'll be using Cursor, but you can use any other tool that supports AI clients like Claude, Windsurf, or VS Code. The setup process can look different depending on the tool you're using, so make sure to check out the documentation specific to your client. To install a new MCP server globally in Cursor, go to Cursor Settings. In the MCP tab, click Add a new global MCP server. This will open the mcp.json file. Copy the configuration from the Wix MCP article linked in the description and paste it in the JSON file, and then save it. If this is the first time you are using the MCP, you'll be directed to your browser to authorize your Wix account. You may also need to periodically reauthorize it later on if the token expires. If everything goes well, you should see Wix MCP remote in your servers with a green dot to the left. You'll also see the Wix services that are available to the MCP. Quick tip, if your MCP doesn't work, as a first troubleshooting tip, run this line in your terminal. This will delete any cached MCP settings and allow you to reconnect the MCP to your Wix account. If you have any additional issues, take a look at the troubleshooting section in the Wix MCP article as well as the MCP debugging guide before proceeding to the next step. Now that we're set up, let's open the AI chat panel and give it a sanity check prompt. List my Wix websites. You'll need to approve each tool call before proceeding to the next step. You can optionally allow the Wix MCP to auto-run without needing to approve every action. You can find this in Cursor Settings. Once we've confirmed that the server is configured, we can move on to perform more complicated tasks like installing and configuring a Wix app. The MCP server works best when we give it as detailed prompts as possible. A prompt for a straightforward action like installing Wix Bookings might look like this. Install Wix Bookings on my site LexPoint Legal. A more complex task like setting up a booking service will have a more detailed set of prompts. First, create a new staff member on my site. His name is Barry Smith. Create a new booking service on my site, LexPoint Legal. The service is a one-on-one appointment. Name it Legal Counseling and assign my staff member, Barry Smith. If I want to add Barry to my booking service with specific hours and a lunch break, it might look something like this. You'll notice the changes reflected in the booking sections of your dashboard. Read the suggestion carefully. Be sure to double-check the dashboard to make sure the correct changes are reflected. You can also use the MCP server to generate Wix SDK code. Let's look at a Wix headless project. Here, we've used the Wix MCP to set up a collection named Team Members. We can then tell the MCP to create an endpoint to retrieve the data from our collection using OAuth. As always, be as specific as possible and make sure to review any changes suggested by the AI agent. Check out the sample prompts page in the documentation for more prompt inspiration. And if you have feedback about the Wix MCP, you can always share it with the Wix team by prompting the client directly. The Wix MCP server is only the beginning of an exciting new era for Wix developers. As the technology improves, we hope it'll help you build sites more quickly and easily. For more information on using MCP in your workflow and to stay updated on the latest Wix features, check out our documentation and join our Discord community linked in the description.